Welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to talk about educational psychology, so let's get into it. Educational psychologist is the same as that of clinical psychologist, but they usually deal with the less serious problems. They work with high school and university students and help them in their adjustment issues, vocational and educational goals. Schools and high schools provide opportunities for psychologists as the serious emotional issues start from the early grade. Many schools employ them who train the teachers along with the courses in education, child development, and clinical psychology. They also do assessments in order to get to know about the issues the child is suffering from and help the child counter it with the most effective coping strategy. Other assessments such as of intelligence, achievement, and personality test are also a part of their job. Educational psychologists collaborate with parents and teachers to make the plans to help the child in both classroom as well as home. Teachers are trained to improve their teaching so to deliver the best of them to the students, and so the students absorb the information at their optimal level. They also motivate students and find ways for engaging them. They also deal with special children and teaching them coping strategies to tackle and cope their obstacles. They also help the child in boosting their confidence, self-confidence, and eliminating the shyness along with the low self-esteem. They conduct researches on how to make teaching method more effective and help train teachers and school psychologists. They also look at the different types of technologies and how it could be beneficial for the student learning. They also create curriculum for maximized learning. The significant figures related to educational field are Alfred Binet, who was the French psychologist who developed the first intelligence test. William James, who gave lectures to teachers as his focus was on teachers and to improve the teaching. John Locke, he gave the concept of tabula rasa. Mind is initially a blank slate at birth, that knowledge is developed through experience and learning. Jean Piaget, he gave the influential theory of cognitive development on how they could contribute in student learning. B.F. Skinner, he gave the idea how rewards and punishments play a role in education today. So this was all about educational psychology. If you liked, do like the video and do subscribe to my channel, because it really supports and motivates me to make more simple and good videos for you. Thanks for watching. Do subscribe my channel. Take care. Bye bye.